Hi folks, welcome to this little presentation. Just wanted to have a quick presentation about creating geometry using bSolid. So we're just going to quickly look at how to create geometry. We'll do it in two parts. First section, creating geometry. So we'll look at setting up your snaps, creating lines, arcs, rectangles and circles. And then we'll do a second video and cover modifying the geometry that you've created. So deleting, moving, copying, cutting and joining. All right, let's get into it. Okay, so this is what we're going to work through. We'll start off by creating some lines around the perimeter of this. Then we'll get into creating some arcs around here, arcs or parts of circles. We'll create some circles in these positions here. Then we'll look at how to create this shape in the middle here by creating a rectangle, drawing four arcs, and then trimming and cleaning that up and joining that back together. So that's our project, and we'll kick off with creating the lines around the outside there. Let's kick off. Okay, over on the left here we've got our drawing tools, so make sure you've got your drawing toolbar selected there. Make sure you're on top view, not back bottom ISO. And before you kick off, just check your object snaps down here, so make sure they're on. You want ortho on. Just check in here, see what we've got. So we've got endpoint, and that's probably all we want for what we'll be doing here. So you go, okay. Start off with a new line over here, enter your initial coordinates. So I want 80, x, 0, y, 0, z. I'm going to take that line down to 340, 0, 0. I'm then going to do another line starting from here. Now, this is why you've got your snaps on. So you can see the cursor's red. When it goes blue, it'll tell you what it's snapped to. Then I put in the coordinates of the next point. So 390, hit the tab key to come down, 50, and Z is still zero. Go okay to that. All right, next line, use your snap. Snap onto the end. Now we're going to go up here. How far are we going to go? 190. So we can put in the coordinates there if we want. So we're still at 390x. Y is going to go all the way up to 240. Okay, hit OK. And you can keep going. Snap your next one. 340, 290. Did I get the last one wrong? Nope, there we go, looking good. All right, so I'm just going to work my way around there, creating new geometry as I go. I'll just pause the recording for a moment and I'll get back to you once I've done some more. Okay, so hopefully you've got your straight line geometry created there. We'll just have a quick look at creating arcs and some of the tricks with that. So you've got your full circles down here, but we want to do some arcs, so we click on our arc tool. The first thing you'll see here, working from top to bottom, different types of arcs. 3 point, 2 points in a radius, 2 points in a center. Okay, so we've got 2 points in a radius. So we start off with our initial point, and we can get that from a snap. If we know our endpoint, pop in your endpoint data. Okay, go enter, and then you're going to need your radius. Now we've been given the radius, so that's good. We can work with that. Radius of 50. Whoop. Keep your mouse over here, please. Radius of 50, and then you need to choose the segment of the circle that you want to use to create this. So that's the one I want. So it's a anti-clockwise, and it's a positive direction. No, negative direction. So it's anti-clockwise, and it's pointing up above the center point. Hit that on OK. Start your next segment. Know your endpoint. So we're back to 0, 145, into that, put in your radius, 50, and choose your segment, and you're good to go. And you can just keep working these around. So from that endpoint to the next point. So we're always going from one endpoint to the next endpoint and putting in our radius. Now, assuming we want different segments, you can choose your different segments as well. So we just choose the one that suits us, and off we go. Again, endpoint from your snap, final point from what you know about your drawing, and hello, why didn't it like that? Oh, that can't possibly be right. That'll be 80, And that will be, here's a little trick I suppose you didn't know. You can type sums in here if you want, and it'll figure them out for you. It's a nice little bit of software. So if you know how to calculate what you want, just type it in there and it'll work that out for you. Probably could snap it as well. I didn't think of that. All right, so there's your arcs. If you're happy with all of that, take the opportunity now to give that a save. Give that a name somewhere and give that a save. We'll overwrite the old one that I've got there. All right, that's great. Okay, so next we'll actually create some circles. So on our drawing, we've got a few circles, so you can use this circle tool here now. Type a circle, again, 3 points, center and radius, center and diameter, 2 points and a radius. So what information have you got? Use that to create your circle. So for us, we know the center point. X is 40, Y is 145, and Z will be 0, and radius of the circle is 10. Okay, so it's really simple. You put in your center point and the radius. Now, if you don't know that information, you can use some other method, one of these other methods to create it. So if you're trying to link to, you can have a 2 point and then give it a radius and that kind of stuff. Okay, so you can just go ahead and create a couple more circles there. So X100, Y20, radius of this one, 5 mm diameter, so 2.5 radius. Go okay. Now we want one on the other side. Now you can enter that data in if you like, and it'll work just as well. Or you could use some other strategies. We could mirror that. If we're further down the line, we could do a few other things as well. But for the sake of this, we'll just create that circle straight off the data. So we still want it same position in. That'll give me that position. Okay, so I know the whole thing's 290 wide. I want to come in 20 from the edge and radius 2.5. Okay, now we want a rectangle. So we'll hit undo to get out of that and create a rectangle. So in here, we're creating that rectangle. Now I know my start corner is going to be, I forget what it's going to be. It's going to be in here somewhere. So it's going to be about 170, I think, and 30. That's too much. That's 110, I think it might be. 110 and 30. Okay, and then the length and the height of it. So it's 200 by 230. How's that look? I reckon that 110 might have been wrong, but anyhow, we'll give it a go at that point. All right. Finish creating rectangles, hit escape. Now, we'll just pause that for a minute there for you to catch up. Okay, so I'm going to create these arcs in the corners here now. So we'll grab our arc tool. We're going to use an X and a Y, 2 points and a radius. So I'll start off with my X coordinate. So 160, 30. My end point will be 110, 80. And hopefully I got this right, radius here should be 50. And select the segment that you want. Go okay. So I'm going to put the same thing in each of the four corners. So start point. This is going to be the top left-hand one. End point will be 160, 260, and 50 mm radius. Oops. And go okay. And get all four of those in there. So my other start point 260, 260, and we'll have 310 and 210, 50, and hello. Whoops. Okay, try that one again. Should have put in 310, but I put in 31. So I couldn't figure that out. Like it just wasn't a real circle. So it's told me it's an error. So if I can't compute the data, it'll give you that error down the bottom there. 50, And there we go. And last one. Last one will be from 310,80 to 260,30. Enter 50. Okay. Go okay. All right. So undo that and we're ready to start doing some modifications. So far we've created some lines, different angles, created some different arcs across the top here and around in here using two points and a radius, and then created our circles based on a center point and a radius. So that's your basic creation tools. All right, so next up we'll look at how to modify some of this and then to do some joining as well. Drawing toolbar. This is down to our modification toolbar. So if you select your modification toolbar, we get a whole bunch of different icons down here. So we're going to start off by dividing this rectangle and then deleting some bits and joining it back together into a polyline. And then we'll look at joining this outside into a polyline. And then we'll create some text and position that using move and rotate. So first off, when you're selecting from left to right, anything that's touched by that box is selected. Okay, so if we start over on the left, it's everything that's completely inside that selection box. Okay, so in this case, we'll go right to left, get all that internal stuff. And we're going to use this little beauty down here, which is called divided intersections, and that will cut your existing geometry at any line that you've created. So we'll hit that one, and you'll see now I can go around and delete these corner segments. Okay, so get rid of those. So now I've got, this is all individual bits of geometry. So what I want to do, again, select all of those pieces and hit the two rings here to join them together. Type of joining, go OK. There's your polyline all nicely joined up. Now we're going to do the same for the outside. It's a bit trickier to select. So you can individually select those or you can create the selection box. Okay, same idea, hit the join button. Okay, now we've got our outside and our inside as continuous pieces of geometry, and we're happy with these circles. So to show how we can use move and rotate, I'm going to first off go back here and create some text, just linear text it's called. This is a good one. Click your start point. Now I'm not too fussed where that is. Pop it in the middle there somewhere. Okay. Put in your text. This frame, this is the A-frame. Adjust the height of your text. You can make it bold. You can center it about your center point, whatever you like. Okay, what's in there? Oh, and you can adjust your spacing a little bit too if you want to make it a bit tighter. We can shrink it down a little bit. Little bit less space in between the characters, you can muck around these, change the direction. Ooh, backwards. Okay, so we're going to close that. There's my text. Now what I want to do is get that sitting vertically across here. So first things first, select the text and we're going to rotate. So back to our modified toolbar, choose a rotation point. At this point in time, not very important, choose a point in the center there and rotate that. Now if you've got ortho on, this will go to the 45 degree points around your axis. So move it to there. So I've got it in the right direction. Now all I want to do is put it in the position I want. Now for this, because I don't know of a good way to move text without how to center this except visually, I just turn off my snaps. So turn off ortho and turn off the object snap and just position that where I like the look of it. So we're going to engrave this with an engraving tool in a minute, but for the time being, let's just pop it down the bottom there. Okay, so that's if I wanted to move it. If I wanted to copy, so let's just say I wanted to copy this one, you use the same tool, but you tick enable copy. So now I'm going to make a copy, put my snap back on. Okay. Where do I want to go? Center point snap. So center of that one. And then it says, where do you want to put your copy? So we'll keep X on same position. So 100X. We're going to make our Y 260. Can't be right. 290 less 30 should be 260. Why doesn't that look right? Don't know. Okay, let's go with that anyhow. Okay, so I've just copied that across there and you can see it works in the same way. Okay, once you're happy with that, give that a save. And you're all good to move on to the next stage, which is to start some machining. So before you do anything else, just save that one there. Okay, so at the top, drawing, next one down, modify, further down, machining operations. So that'll be our next job, is to get into the machining operations. All right, so I'll just click on that one and we'll leave that there and we'll come back in a minute and do some machining.